Great to see you back. In this video, we're going to demo how you can use Azure AD ConnectHealth, an ADFS activity report on Azure AD to help you discover and prioritize your applications.
To gain visibility on what's going on your ADFS farm, you may want to install Azure AD ConnectHealth. This is our monitoring tool for Azure AD Connect and ADFS, and it's very easy to install and configure. The ConnectHealth agent for ADFS reads the configuration, performance counter, and event logs, and send it to the cloud where we ingest the data and provide operational best practices and usage insights. Let's go to the ADFS console. Here we can see the reliant party trust. And since we install Azure AD ConnectHealth in the ADFS farm, I can go back to the Azure AD portal. Enterprise Applications, Usage and Insights, ADFS Application Activity. Here I can see all the ADFS relying party trusts, but we also see which ones are ready to migrate to Azure AD.
Yeah, one thing that I find very cool here is that we show the total number of users by each app. But I want to emphasize that is not a trivial question to answer in a consolidated way across multiple servers in the ADFS farm without ConnectHealth. This is a big piece of data for your migration effort because this helps you to prioritize what applications have the most usage based on the count. We see a lot of very old ADFS deployments that have lots of relying party trust, but they have no traffic. So customers shouldn't even be spending time looking those stale applications.
Let's preview the first one. This is ServiceNow. This is a SaaS app. We can see the different checks we do on the ADFS configuration. It seems that the app is ready to be migrated to Azure AD. Also, we can check other apps that may need some review, like Claim X-Ray. So if we go in, we can see that we run the same checks, but in this case, two of them requires to review the existing configuration. For example, issuance transformation rules. This may not be fully compatible with Azure AD as they are. In this case, we can see that one of the rules is using a regex transformation. So Azure AD supports regex transformations, but since we don't know exactly what you're trying to do here, then we provide links to documentation so you can learn more how to transform this and migrate to Azure AD.
Yeah, so parsing the ADFS rules is definitely not an easy task. So this is very, very helpful and customers should definitely take advantage of it to estimate the effort to migrate those applications.
It seems that we have done our first demo.
Well, after the demo that Luis showed us, we went from this initial state that we saw in the previous video with all the infrastructure, and we added Azure AD ConnectHealth, which is a very lightweight. And what it does for us is to get all the information from on-premises traffic configuration and sends it all over the cloud. So then that's how you will see the analytics for the next step of the migration journey. So in the next video, we're going to see how you can take that information and start migrating your first app. So see you in the next one.